Good afternoon. This is Rich Nass, Executive Vice President of Open Systems Media and leader of the Embedded and IoT franchises. I am here for this week's installment of 5 Minutes With. This week, I'm speaking to Bill Diotte, who is the CEO of Mocana, who you probably know is one of the leaders in security. Good afternoon, or I guess it'll be morning in your case. Bill, how are you?
I'm doing well, Rich. Thank you.
So you guys are obviously in security, and everybody's into the IoT. I'm amazed. I'm still seeing hack after hack on a huge scale. Why is that? Is it that people are lazy? Is it that the hackers are smarter than us? Why do we just continue to see this over and over and over?
Well, that's pretty simple. Great question, but pretty simple. It's really based on the fact that we're not focusing on preventing the problem by hardening the devices, enabling the devices out there to protect themselves, quite frankly. And until we do that, the infrastructure will continue to be vulnerable to these types of attacks.
Did you just throw this over the wall to the hardware folks?
No, actually, you know, we think of devices as a stack of hardware and software together. And in fact, we work with the hardware manufacturers to help enable the features that are going into silicon, and with the software makers with firmware and operating system security components. So really, it's a combined effort that we've really got to get serious about together. The problem is that it's just been too darn difficult up to this point to really enable that in a way that product teams can get their arms around.
And it's difficult. Why?
Well, it's difficult for a couple of reasons. Number one, as I said, there's a lot of great technology being implemented in the silicon and the chipsets that are coming out. But the problem is the access to the developer community is still a pretty tough road to hoe. There's literally thousands of pages of documentation that you have to understand, read, and be able to use to access those features effectively. And they don't speak the API language that developers want to speak, Java, Python, C even. So it's really the features are there, but they're not very accessible primarily.
And what will it take to make that change?
Well, I think a couple of things. Number one, there's got to be new tool sets out there. And obviously, Mocana is leading the way in some of those areas to create a full stack that's accessible by developers using user-friendly, developer-friendly interfaces. That's number one. Number two is a lot more education and resources given to product teams. I mean, these teams are under pressure to get product out. They're focused on fantastic features. The ability to enable strong security woven into the design of those products needs to be made much more simple and as natural as the product design process. So I think really those two key features, the usable tool sets and the education and the resources to get this work done are two key elements.
I hate to sound like such a downer, but I think what it's going to take is something bad has to happen. You know, I mean, loss of life or something like that, you know, because we're a very reactionary society, and that's what seems to motivate people. Am I being too much of a pessimist?
No, you know, unfortunately, we always hope that that the message is going to be, embraced. But at the same time, in many cases, you're right. I mean, we don't really think about the downside until it's staring us in the face. It's unfortunate, but I do believe on a more hopeful note that many of the executive leadership teams of these companies that make devices, the board level, is starting to really get a fresh understanding of what this means to them from a risk profile management, what it could mean to an impact of the brand of the company. Now, those are billion-dollar issues that they're starting to get their heads wrapped around, let alone loss of life and safety issues with respect to mission-critical industrial networks as well. So we're hopeful, but at the same time, some of the recent attacks we've seen ought to be a wake-up call to the industry as a whole.
So without getting too far into the weeds and into the promotion, what are you guys doing to help this problem?
Well, as I mentioned, we're hard at work making developer-friendly tools. And what we believe in as a fundamental foundation of cybersecurity for IoT is that you have to have trusted devices. And trusted devices really is three legs of a stool. Number one, to ensure that you can measure a trusted boot of a known good firmware and operating system. that comes up when the device boots up. Secondly, secure and trusted update. Any update to that firmware, BIOS, operating system needs to, again, be certified, secure, cryptographically measured before it is updated. And then secure operations, which means essentially authentication and traffic communication allowed only between trusted devices that have gone through a secure boot, secure update process. So when you do that, you've created an operating environment that is vastly more difficult to compromise. And in fact, in most cases, it just won't be compromised. And even if it is, it's one device at a time, and you have to break multiple strong keys and multiple certificates in order to get through that. That really throws a monkey wrench into the rapid spread in the form of the things we've seen in the past. And we think that goes a long way to protect the infrastructure.
Will it forever be a race? People like Mocana, against the bad guys?
Yeah, absolutely. Absolutely. You know, the bad guys have a particular motive or a couple of sets of different motives. We're evolving into cyber warfare from cyber crime, and this is just going to be part of the new reality. And, you know, the wake-up call is all around us. We've got to protect these devices and give them self-defense lessons, let's put it that way, so each device can protect itself. And this is going to be an ongoing battle as far as the eye can see.
Okay. Well, let's hope you guys win.
We're planning on it, Rich.
Okay. That was Bill Diotte. He is the CEO of Mocana, and he was my guest on this week's 5 Minutes With. I'm Rich Nass, Open Systems Media. Thank you, Bill. Have a great day.
Thanks, Rich. You too.